Before you can upgrade the firmware in the camera, it's essential to have a fully charged battery in the camera. If it's not fully charged, the process will not begin. So check on the back of the camera that the battery display is showing at least 3 bars. If it's fully charged, the process will start. So with the binary file loaded on your SD card and the SD card in the camera, all you need to do is then press the replay button, that's the green arrow, to begin the process. The camera now checks if there's a binary file on the SD card first of all, and if the version is greater than the one in the camera, it will allow you to upgrade. So select yes and then press menu to begin the process. Now during this process it's essential that you don't press any of the buttons on the camera, otherwise you'll cause the upgrade to fail. So to recap, so far we've downloaded the executable file from the Japanese global site, we've created the binary file and transferred that over to the SD card, plugged the SD card in the camera, gone into the replay mode and pressed the replay button, and the camera has checked the upgrade version is greater than the one in the camera and is now performing the upgrade version for you. At the end of the upgrade, it will initialize and go back to the usual display menu. If you wanted to check the version has gone in completely, go to the Tools menu, that's the one with the spanner or wrench icon, and step through to page 4. At the top of page 4, you'll see we have the version display. Press version display, menu set, and you can see we've got version 2.0. If you press the menu set button, it will give you the software license info. And that's the process of upgrading the camera firmware. So what does version 2 firmware upgrade give us with the FZ330? Before I demonstrate the new features, I'm going to set a reference picture. Here I've got the aperture set to f2.8, the calculated exposure is 1/80th of a second, I've got ISO 160. I've got the camera set to autofocus single area method, and I'm going to set my focus point using my F4 key, which I've got pre-programmed to give me the option to change the focus point. I'll set them on the eyes of this first character, and we'll take the first shot to show you the amount of depth of field at this particular point of focus. It's going to be shallow because we're at f2.8 and I've got a fairly amount of extension of zoom on there, so the background character is going to be out of focus. Hopefully with the new version 2 firmware upgrade, we'll be able to select that point for focus. The new post focus feature is on page 3 of the record setup menu. And you notice that it's there at the bottom of the menu and it's either off or we turn it on. When we turn it on, the camera switches to the 49 area select mode and it will take the picture and determine the focus at those 49 points. So we'll take the picture again using the new upgraded software. And you can see that it stepped through and tried to analyse which of those points would have sharp focus. It's now building up the sequence file for us to select the point we want. So for example, if I wanted this first character to be in focus, I can either tap him, so I can select him on screen and find the nearest 49 area point to it, or I can use the navigation keys to step through the whole image until I find one of those 49 areas that covers the point that I want to see in focus. To finally select the focus, you can either then select using the plus key, which will give you a magnified view of the area you've selected, and then you can use the navigation key left and right to change the actual focus point of that point in the image. So once I've got the principal focus set, press menu set to go into the save menu, select yes, and press menu set again to save it. So now, for example, if I wanted this lady in the background to be in focus, I tap her and that gives me the nearest area to it. Again, I can use the plus key or use the zoom key to the telephoto position, and that will give me the enlarged view at that point of the image. So now I can use the navigation buttons again just to find the point that I want to be exactly in focus, press menu set and save the image. The F2 key controls focus peaking. So if you didn't want the green outlines on the image which are in focus, if you press the F2 key, that will turn it off. So if I now wanted to view this little character here, touch the point, use the zoom key towards the telephoto position, and now I can use the navigation keys left and right to set the focus point that I deem to be the central focus. Press menu set and then save the image. If you've come out of that particular image, you can go back to it as you can with the 4K shooting mode. All you have to do is go back into the replay mode. You get the option to go into post focus play, use the up arrow key, and that will again build the image sequence for you. And then you can go ahead and choose the subject that you want to be in focus. If you want to check the focus again, use the zoom key towards the telephoto position. And then you can use your navigation buttons to set the focus point precisely where you need it. Press menu set and then save the image. So that is the new version 2 firmware upgrade to give you post focus. I'm going to try it out on some dynamic images, so there's going to be some movement in the subject. It's fine here on the tabletop with a static subject and I've got the camera mounted on a tripod. I have tried some handheld shots and it does give you a good result. But the proof of the pudding now will be on a dynamic capture where we've got some subject motion, how the camera will respond to changing in focus depth with moving subjects.